In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth.
Bring the word, other gifts and talents.
Thank you. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers. I say hey to my mother and sister, Elder Johnson from my home church. Thank you, Pastor and First Lady, for asking. I was like Jason. I was going to say no, but Pastor said God laid it on his heart. And I was like, man, if I'm asking God to do a lot for me and my family, it's wrong to tell him no. I won't be up for you long. This is 10 minutes is my thing. I spoke at my home church. 10 minutes is good for me. I'm going to be coming from Psalms 23:1. And it says, that's a very passage that everybody should know. It says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Let me say it again. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. To give you a little application, this book was written by David. And some theologians said that it was written when Saul was after David. This is six verses. This text is short, but it's broken up into two parts. Verses 1 and 4 is God is a good shepherd, and verses 5 and 6 is God is a gracious host. Now, if you're doing the studying, it says a prayer of confidence that David was speaking about God. It's a prayer of acknowledging who he is in his life. Psalms 23, when it has that word my in it, it's personal. It's telling about it's a one-on-one relationship having with God. It's not just the flock and God, but it's the shepherd and his sheep, which who you are. And that's for you have a relationship. You have to first confess your sins and say that Jesus died for you on the cross and that you believe in him in order to have a relationship. It's going to go to my first point. I told you I won't be long. First point is when you look at the word Lord, that you know that's the Father who's God. But what is God? God is a guardian. You know, a guardian, he protects and keeps us. God takes care of us, natural and spiritual. And therefore, most of us know that we have fathers here that just do things naturally, but they don't do things spiritually. So God does both, and he's a great example of what a father here on earth should be. The second point I'm having is the word shepherd. And a shepherd, what is a shepherd? A shepherd is a guide. A guide is where God directs our steps in every which way that we should go. God is our compass, and the word is our map. You know, most of us, we can say that we can get an address to a place, but we don't know how to get there. And so when we have God as our compass and his word as our map, we can't go lost in our work with him. You know, God not only leads us in our right paths, but God leads us in the righteous paths. So after knowing what the guardian is and that you know what the guide is, Here it is that God is our giver, which the part is, I shall not want. And so with God, there is no lack. God is the source for our needs, and it's in his will that everything that we should have is according to him. You can look at Deuteronomy 2, so you won't get misconstrued when it says, I shall not want, because most people think that whatever they have up before God, he gonna give you. But if you look at Deuteronomy 2, when the children, the Israelites was in the wilderness, it said that even though they was there, God was still with them, which is no lack. It was for the best of their well-being. In Deuteronomy 8, it showed that Moses told him God starved them just to see their faithfulness to him and if they keep their commands. So just as good things that we have that God give us and those that he don't give us, it shows that it's for our best, because some things can be set up, like Jason said, people can deceive you. It can be a trap, but if you were his flock, his sheep, he will block that from you. Yeah. So with that said, I got four answers, since you know this is a prayer of confidence and acknowledging God. It's four answers when you pray to him. The first one is a yes. You can write this down so you know when you're praying, you can go to these and say, okay. The first one is a yes answer. The second one is a no. The third one is not right now. And the fourth one, which is great, is my grace is sufficient. I thank you and I appreciate you for this time.